And when Muharram is in every mosque, a name appears alongside every lover. When you
her loyalty to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein salamullahi alayhi, Allah raised her status to the point where when you have a haja, any need, you do tawassul through this lady Ummul Baneen and Allah will help you.
This is Abbas's mother.
And one very important lady as well is a noble, virtuous lady by the name of Ummul Baneen, salamullahi alayha. This is the mother of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, salamullahi alayhi, and his three other brothers. This lady, her real name was Fatima. Fatima bint Hizam al-Kilabiyya from Bani Kalb. Imam Ali alayhi salam told his brother Aqil, "Brother, I want a lady who's virtuous and she comes from a brave tribe." Aqil knew the tribes, the Arabic tribes. Now someone might ask, why would Imam Ali need to ask Aqil? He's alim, he's imam. Imam Ali is teaching us a lesson that if you want to get married, ask about the person and seek advice from experts. So he went to someone who's an expert in this field. That's to teach us a lesson, not that he needed the advice. But again, he's teaching us lessons. You don't have to know the person 5 years in advance. If you know about the family, if she comes from a good family, he comes from a good family, you can talk with the permission of the parents, you can discuss with the permission of your parents, get to know, and if things look good, inshallah, tawakkalu ala Allah. Khalas. Aqil goes and asks her father's permission. He accepts, she agrees. And the marriage occurs. She comes to Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullahi alayhi, as a young bride. The first day in the house, Imam Ali alayhi salam calls her, "Ya Fatima." She calls him, she says, "Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I have a request." "Yes." "Please do not call me Fatima anymore." "But that is your name. Why not?" "Because I am afraid that if Hassan and Hussein and Zainab and Umm Kulthum, my masters, sadati," that's the word she used, "sadati, my masters, if they hear you calling me with the name of their mother Fatima, that might bring grief to their hearts. They might remember their mother. So I don't want to be a source of grief to these people. These are the children of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi." Look at the nobility of this lady. Who would have thought about this? A bride on the first day. So Imam Ali alayhi salam then said, "Well, Allah is going to grant me 4 boys from you. So I'm going to call you Ummul Baneen, the mother of the boys." And that became her title and her name since that day. Brothers and sisters, subhanallah, this lady is not a mother of an imam, nor is she a ma'suma, yet because of her love to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein, her sacrifice to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein, her loyalty to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi, Allah raised her status to the point where when you have a haja, any need, you do tawassul through this lady Ummul Baneen and Allah will help you. Try reciting 100 salawat and give the thawab to Ummul Baneen and inshallah Allah will ease your haja, will fulfill your haja. Or have another to do a majlis for Ummul Baneen. If Allah fulfills this, you can say lillahi nadhrun alay. If Allah fulfills this need for me, I will have a majlis for Ummul Baneen. And you'll see, several years ago, in 2011, I was put in prison, brothers and sisters. And some of you are aware of the incident. In the prison there, I did tawassul through Ummul Baneen, salamullahi alayha. That's one of the things I did, among several other things. I did salat al-istighatha bil-zahra, salamullahi alayha. Salat al-istighatha bi our Imam, ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif, which are found in Mafatihul Jinan, and prayed 100 rak'at salat and gifted the thawab to Fatima, salamullahi alayha, Ummul Baneen, and the Imam al-Baqir. And I did a tawassul, another, that if Allah were to release me, I will hold a majlis for Ummul Baneen. Less than 24 hours later, I was supposed to be deported, but I was freed, released, and I continued my hajj with the barakah of Ahlul Bayt, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. This is a personal experience, not something I've read in the books. This lady, Ummul Bani, when she called Hassan and Hussein and Zainab and Umm Kulthum, salamullah alayhim, my masters, well, that's what she taught her son, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Therefore, Abu al-Fadl would never call Imam al-Hussein by his name. He would not even call him brother. He always calls him Sayyidi Aba Abdullah. You see where that comes from? When you have such a great mother. When Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas was born, salamullahi alayhi, she brings him happily, delivers him to Amir al-Mu'mineen, alayhi salam. Imam Ali opens and unwraps him. He was wrapped in a cloth. He unwraps the cloth. He looks at the little hand of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. He kisses the hand of this boy and his tears flow. Ummul Baneen gets worried. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, is there something wrong with the hands of my son? Why are you crying? He says, no, Ya Ummul Baneen, there is nothing wrong with his hands. But there will be a day when these hands will be sacrificed as he defends his brother Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. Ummul Baneen alayha salam remembers. So when the family wanted to leave from Medina to head to Mecca, and then from there the plan was to go to Kufa, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas was summoned by his mother Ummul Baneen. She says, come to me, son. He comes. Yes, mother. And he speaks with utmost respect to his mother. She says, son, ya Abu al-Fadl, you're going on this journey. I want you to take care of Hussein and Zainab alayhim as-salam. They are your masters. They are the children of my master Fatima al-Zahra. I want you to make me proud in front of as-Sayyida Fatima on the day of judgment. I want to stand there proudly saying, my master, Ya Bint Rasulullah, I sacrificed all my boys for you.
Without her mourning, none would let, and no chest by hands would be hit. For Hussein, none would despair.